Hey everyone, this is Adam Kenyon, level 4 trainer from Hamilton's Upper James GoodLife Fitness, to answer a few of our members' questions from Twitter this week. One person asks, a friend started taking boot camp classes a few months ago and she said that she's noticed she's losing inches but not weight. Why is that? That's a great question. It's something that trainers usually do a good job of explaining during personal health profiles, and that is the difference between total body weight and body composition. Our bodies are composed of many different things, as we all know, bones, muscles, liquids, etc. All of these things combined are our body composition. Now, what is most likely happening to your friend is that hers is changing. While she is attending her boot camp, there is a great likelihood that she is growing muscle and burning fat at the same time. And as we all know, muscle outweighs fat. And so when you stand on a scale and you're looking at the number, you might become actually horrified that that number is actually going up. Although you are looking and feeling a lot better, the numbers on the scale are, like I said, going up. So my suggestion would be get rid of the scale. I understand that it is some sort of a marker for you, and it may help your friend gauge where she is in terms of her success, but so is the way that she feels and how she fits into her clothes and how she looks at herself in the mirror, and that's really the real measure of success. That's ultimately what we're going to be happy about. It's not a number on the scale. If you need to track numbers, maybe you can ask any GoodLife personal trainer at your specific gym if they'd be willing to assist you in doing a body composition on a Tanita machine, or perhaps tracking inches using a measuring tape. Everybody at the gym is always willing to help, so just ask one of them. Another number that she could track is basically the number of compliments that she gets. The next question comes from Megan. Megan asks, what are your thoughts on doing body pump multiple days in a row? Is it harmful or can it be beneficial? It's another great question, Megan, one that I've been asked many times. Body pump is a phenomenal way to burn a lot of calories through high repetition and low weight movements. It is a full body program incorporating every single primal pattern movement in order to ensure that your body is getting the work that it deserves. Unfortunately, because of that fact, that is exactly why your body also needs to rest. When we are training, we are actually putting stress onto our bodies, a good stress, but stress nonetheless. It is when we are recovering that we make our greatest gains in terms of muscle growth or fat loss. If we consistently put our bodies through the grinder without giving them a break, we do not allow it to recover and thus actually add more stress to that particular muscle group or groups. Now, I know you mentioned whether body pump on multiple days is a good thing, but this goes to say whether you're doing a chest and back workout, well, you shouldn't do another chest and back workout the following day. A great way to offset your body pump regimen would be to partake in another one of GoodLife's newest yoga fit or body flow classes, for example, which are much less intense and focus on that recovery aspect that I was just talking about. By giving your body that time to heal, you are also preparing yourself to achieve optimum results the next time you go into your body pump class. Now, I know that this probably won't sit well with many of you hardcore body pump fanatics, but understand that you will get better results faster by giving yourself that break, both with sleep and getting those 7 to 9 hours of 7 to 9 hours of sleep per night, as well as resting those muscles that you worked before. So take a look at your club schedule and figure out what your own routine would be, and stick with it for 6 weeks, and then maybe switch it up to avoid any sort of plateauing. The final question comes from Natasha. Natasha is looking for some quick and easy exercises to do inside the office with about 20 to 30 minutes time. It's not a lot of time to do a workout, and I totally understand how you feel in terms of making that time for yourself and your fitness. This is one of the primary reasons GoodLife Fitness actually offers the FitFix circuit. It's for busy people like yourself who do not have a lot of time to work on themselves but still want to get things done. If you cannot make it to the gym, however, and you do have minimal time available during your lunch hour, for example, I would suggest you partake in some Tabata training. Tabata is a great way for you to improve your body composition as well as your cardiovascular health. Now, you'll need a pair of dumbbells, perhaps around 10 pounds each, to get a good effective workout in, and a tubing band that is usually available at any sports or fitness store. What Tabata training is 20 seconds of continuous intense work followed by 10 seconds of rest. And it's basically like a circuit. You repeat that about 7 more times in the traditional Tabata way. So when you do the math, you're looking at about 4 minutes of actual work, toss in a 5-minute warm-up and a 5-minute cooling stretch down. There's your 20 minutes. What I've done is actually developed a quick and easy circuit that you can do every other day on your lunch break, adding in one extra exercise so that the work is about 10 minutes long. Throw in a 5-minute warm-up and a 5-minute cool-down, and you should have a nice workout regimen for at least a little while. I have my client Kevin, who is going to be demonstrating the exercises for you, coming up right now, and then right after that, I'll show exactly what the split should be for the day 1, day 2, and day 3.
Shuffling. Step up fast and be the first girl to make me throw this cash. We get money, don't be mad. Now stop, hating is bad. One more shot for us, another round. Please fill up a cup, don't mess around. We just want to see you shaking out. Now you home with me.
Get down, put your hands up to the sun. Get down, put your hands up to the sun. Get down, put your hands up to the sun. Put your hands up to the sun. Put your hands up to the sun.
That's it for now. I want to thank all of those who submitted questions and apologize to those that I was not able to answer. If you'd like to submit a question, you can do so by following me on Twitter at PTAdamK or going to my website at www.ackenya.com. Remember, to succeed, you need to have action, commitment, and knowledge.